Hi, I'm Veronica Wasek, and I help virtual bookkeeping pros to become confident professionals and business owners. In this video, I'll talk about the paid diagnostic review and why it's every bookkeeper's weapon for taking on QuickBooks Online cleanup projects. After doing hundreds of cleanups, the number one tool that I have used consistently and that has led to profitable cleanups and also providing additional services to my clients is the paid diagnostic review. I'll explain what the paid diagnostic review is and how you can use it effectively for your bookkeeping business. Okay, so let's start by defining what is a cleanup. A cleanup is when we're taking a client who's using QuickBooks Online and they have messy and incomplete books. Our goal is to review the books, catch them up, fix the books, and reconcile them. And the end result should be that we are now providing the client with complete, accurate, and tax-ready books. But there are a lot of challenges when taking on cleanup clients. You're not getting paid to diagnose the books ahead of time. You have no idea what's wrong with the books. You have no idea how to price the cleanup because you don't even know what you're getting into. You're pricing by the hour, but the client gets sticker shock when they get your invoice. And that happened to me quite a bit in the beginning. There's no agreement with the client on a desired outcome, and the client tries to control the process. The strategy that I developed to overcome all of these challenges is doing a paid diagnostic review. The first goal when doing the paid diagnostic review is to get a full scope of work before you clean up or catch up the books. So just like a doctor would diagnose you before prescribing a treatment, doing the diagnostic review allows you to first get a full scope of work before you ever take on a large project such as a cleanup. The second goal is to get paid to assess the books. The paid diagnostic review is a paid project. It allows you to assess the health of your client's QuickBooks Online data. It helps you to diagnose problems and assess the level of cleanup needed. It allows you to identify transactions that need to be brought up to date. You get a clear scope of work before you ever take on that cleanup, and also it enables you to offer additional services to your client. So how do we offer a paid diagnostic review to our prospective clients? When talking to a prospective client, they will generally tell you all of their pain points. They'll tell you that their books are messed up, that maybe their previous bookkeeper disappeared, that they've tried to do their own books, and it didn't go well, that they connected QuickBooks to an app and that didn't go well either. So they'll tell you all of these things and you need to train yourself to listen for those things. So when they finish telling you all of their pain points, then you're going to recommend the paid diagnostic review. And notice how I use the word recommend, because we're not going to sell, we're going to recommend the service. Here's what you can say. I recommend doing a paid diagnostic review of your books so that I can get a clear picture of what's wrong with your books. At the end of my review, I will go over my findings with you. I will also give you upfront pricing for my services. Now let's go over some workflow basics when doing the paid diagnostic review. We're going to perform the paid diagnostic review. We're going to prepare a report of findings and recommendations and go over that report with our client. And then we're going to recommend additional services. So what goes into performing the diagnostic review? It's really important to use a checklist so that you can cover all of the areas that you need to review. For example, the things that you need to be looking at, whether the balance sheet on the books reconciles to a balance sheet on the tax return, if there is one, banking and credit card accounts, undeposited funds, profit and loss accounts, balance sheet accounts, accounts receivable and accounts payable agings, the chart of accounts, products and services list, and areas such as payroll, inventory, and sales taxes if they're tracking that in QuickBooks Online. Here's an excerpt from my diagnostic review checklist. This is what I review for in the income section. I'm looking for unusual balances in the income account, uncategorized income, balances in sales of product income or services, any loan proceeds recorded as income, any sales taxes recorded as a deduction to income. There may be more things that I will check for depending on the type of client and their industry. I'm looking for any errors that have been made, I will make a note on my checklist, and I will also make a note of additional details such as number of transactions found, the date range, and the dollar amount of the transactions that need to be corrected. All right, so let's talk about the report of findings and recommendations. Here's a sample cover sheet of the report of findings and recommendations. As you can see, it is a professional report that we are providing our client. Here's an excerpt from my sample report of findings and recommendations for the profit and loss review. And as you can see, we're listing all of the items that we found and the recommendations for getting all of that cleaned up. After you present the report of findings and recommendations to your client, your next goal is to then present additional services to them, such as cleaning up their books, catching them up, monthly bookkeeping, or coaching and training. Are you using paid diagnostic reviews? Let me know in the comments. Let's get that conversation going. If this content is helping you, then subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and give me a thumbs up. And check the description below for all of my resources, including my free Virtual Bookkeeper's Toolbox, the link to join my Facebook community, and the link to learn more about my online academy for bookkeepers. I'll see you next time.